that we truly can make a difference. For some of us, that might be a little card in the mail. It could be your birthday. It could be, I'm thinking of you. Whatever. It could be a phone call. And now maybe even more frequently, a text. Again and again and again, I see people requesting on Facebook for us to pray. And I see replies constantly. I am praying. I will pray. I do pray. That's okay. I believe those responses. But what they asked us for was a prayer. Step out. Write them a prayer. You're hiding. They can't see you. Write them a prayer. God, I don't know the situation, but I trust that you do. Be with them. Touch them. Strengthen them. Whatever your prayer is, just put down a few words. Let the Spirit of God work through them. I get laughed at for being looking at Facebook here the other night at the play. Somebody came in and sat down in front of me, and the minute they turned around, they said, "Oh, you're looking at that Facebook." It can be a tool. And I literally believe the Spirit of God can even work through us in spite of us using Facebook, social media. It's the world. But the world does not have to control it, because God can. The text goes just a little bit further, and it talks about greater works. I'm about done if you need to get your shoes on. About even greater works. Jesus tells Philip and the disciples that you can do even greater works than me. And they're going, "Are you serious?" And they're beginning to reminisce of all the things that Jesus had done. Calling Lazarus back from the grave, touching the little girl and saying, "Talitha kum, get up, rise up." And he's saying that you can go and do greater things. What? How could that be? How could we possibly do greater things than Jesus himself, who just says, "God is in me and I am in God and I am one. But you're also in me," he said. And through this advocate of the Holy Spirit of God, the very presence of God that is in each of us and has entrusted us with the abilities, the opportunities to be there, to be able to reach out, to love and to care and to encourage each other. To make possible things that otherwise might not happen. Rather than let someone just slide on down the gutter or the ditch, maybe whatever, that we can make that kind of difference. Catch fire. Do greater works. Catch the fire. I put it on the sign out here, and nobody's called to ask me yet. I'd love to have a bonfire here this evening. I'd like to hear the sirens. Some of you with me? Todd's already thinking, "I got a skid steer and some wood over there." I'd like to hear the fire trucks coming from all over Athens, you know, wondering. Well, that is a physical fire. What I'm talking about is a spiritual fire. Do you recall how many disciples Jesus had? At this point, he had 11. They hadn't quite yet brought in. But from this point, they began and they began to spread. And more and more and more began to catch fire. The first revival that Peter did, 3,000 right there. We're a part of that. Several thousand years away now. But it's the same Spirit. It's the very same Spirit that descended on Jesus that he's talking about here today that literally birthed the Christian church. Y'all look excited. That's my brothers and sisters. When you go from here and you share the excitement catching the fire of the Holy Spirit of God, to where you believe that anything that God needs to happen will happen, that others too will want to come and to want. Our closing hymn is 21:17. The actual hymn name to this is the Dove Song, which we know that figure for us is the dove descending, that descended on Jesus at his baptism, that descended on those there in that time of Pentecost. The same Spirit that descends upon us. Open yourself. Open yourself up. Catch the fire. And you too will do greater things than you ever did.